David Lovejoy with KGNC News Radio. We're here with Judge Richard Herman. He's seeking re-election to the Potter County Justice of the Peace Precinct 2. Welcome, Mr. Herman. How are you doing, Judge?
We're doing fine.
Good to see you. Good to see you, sir. Just some quick questions. First off, tell the people a little bit about yourself.
Well, I grew up on Buchanan Street here in Amarillo, Texas. I was a frequent flyer at the Mavericks Boys Club. Matter of fact, I go over there all the time. It's in my precinct, and I just, you know how we are, romantics. And it's just a vacant parking lot now, but that vacant parking lot used to be a two-story house. My World War I grandfather was there. My World War II grandfather was there. Of course, my mom and my aunts and uncles and then us grand. We all lived under one roof, and man, it was happy times. And I remember it. I remember watching my grandma feed the hobos off the back porch, and I always wondered how she could make one potato go so far, you know.
Yeah.
A lot of mouths to feed.
Right, right.
And then I left Amarillo, and after a while, I think I joined the military when I was 18. I served my country for over a 30-year time span, and I've been very blessed. I've been to places like England, where I was honorary knighted by the Queen of England during her birthday for foreign service. I've been in Germany, Italy, all the different European countries, all the NATO countries.
Right.
And then I've been in the Middle East in combat, led soldiers in combat. Matter of fact, I like to tell people, you know, I'm on borrowed time now. I'm living my life for those that ain't here anymore, you know. And I take each day like it's a gift. And I came back to Amarillo when I was living off of Grand Street, and I had talked to some friends, and it was just something about me, you know. I had a servant's heart. I like to help other people, and I seen that this was something that I could do, and I could actually have a positive influence in my community and restore hope, you know, and faith, and make people believe in opportunity again, you know. And I just like to be an example and give our kids a dream. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They can look at me and think about, this guy grew up on Buchanan. I didn't get secondhand shoes. I got third and fourth hand shoes, okay?
Yeah.
And people can look at me, and I can talk to young people and say, this is what you can do if you put your mind to it. And it gets them to dreaming, and it makes them believe there's opportunity. And that's the greatest thing we can give our kids is, you know, opportunity to succeed.
That's it. Now, tell the people why you're seeking re-election.
Well, that's a long story here.
Go ahead.
You know, when I took over the office, there was, I mean, thousands of backlog cases, okay? There was the first year and a half, it was probably 70-80-hour work weeks, and that was just getting rid of all the backlog places, because you can't just go dismissed on them all. You got to go through them. You got to have the hearings and have a docket calls and stuff like that. Over time, we started getting it down to where we were working a normal work week. Well, then all of a sudden, the courthouse got flooded, and that put us back behind. We was having to beg, borrow, and steal for everything, you know, as far as using other people's courts. And you'd go home at night, and you'd have the cases in your mind because you were just working so hard. And, but in the end, we got up on top of it, and we ended up disposing of a 12,000, well, it was more than 12,000 criminal records, got rid of all the backlog cases. I can say not only are we within the state recommended time frames on all of our cases, we're actually less than that at this point. We've saved thousands of dollars, you know, for the taxpayers by doing a thorough inquests, you know, and I constantly seek self-improvement. You know, we were in school together.
Right.
I believe education's fun.
Right.
And so I'm always looking at new ways of cutting out things that don't need to be in a process. And that way we can better serve our citizens. But what I really want to work on now, I have this idea on working with the veterans.
Right.
Okay. And what I would like to implement is an earlier way of identifying our veterans as they come into the system so that we can put them in contact with the help they've earned, you know, because some of these guys are suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder, and they deserve it, and it's important. Yeah. And I'd also like to work more on the domestic violence angle. I still believe, as a magistrate, there's a way that I could institute something similar to a BIP, battery intervention program, mm-hmm. and I think that would work better at keeping families together, but making them work to learn how to communicate. Because you know, and I know, most of the time, what happens when there's anger, it's because we've run out of words to say.
There you go.
But there were some of the things,
and that you're looking to move forward with.
Yes.
Now, this coming up election, is it important to have someone who already knows the systems, because they can hit the ground running once they take office? How important is that for tax dollars, for the taxpayer, and for the citizens?
Okay. I'll show you something. You ever been to the doctor?
Yes.
Okay.
Too many times.
Do you want to go see the doctor that is right some of the time or right all the time?
All the time.
When you replace someone in the judicial system like myself, you're going to get someone who's not ready to hit the ground, okay? And so, therefore, you're going to get someone who's right part of the time, okay? Which one do you want? That's all I'm going to say. But on the other hand, now I'm going to say this, and it may not be smart. We all put our pants on one leg at a time, and we have to be forgiven, and we got to understand. In my heart, I don't believe people get up in the morning and set out to do bad things. I think sometimes our alarm clock don't go off, or we get up and maybe the hot water's gone, or maybe someone else is in the bath. There's things that happen that set it the tone, and so bad things happen to good people, you know, and I think that's kind of important, and that's something I bring to the table that I don't believe nobody else can do it, you know.
That you know. You know
that I know. That's opposing me. Let me rephrase. I don't think they can do it the same way.
Great, great. Well, good luck in your run for your position. Of course, early voting is going on now. The March primary is March 6th. Thank you, Judge Herman, for taking time out. And from one veteran to another, appreciate your service.
Appreciate you.
Appreciate everything you do.
Thank you.
All right.
I appreciate you.